Welcome back to Pathologic Classic HD. I'm kind of entering panic mode here because there's only 3 hours left in the day and I haven't even completed the main quest, let alone the two uncompleted side quests. We got the one with the villains, basically, the bad guys, the people that have been murdering civilians in the streets. And then I also have the one where I'm supposed to get evidence that the district here is completely clear of the infection to Victor. But I think I'm going to have to leave those quests and just focus on the main quest in the hopes that I can even get it done, because I need to get the main quest done for the day or I'm pretty well screwed. So I'm just going to focus on the main quest, and if I can get that done, then after that, I'll evaluate how much time I have left. So let's do it. What I need to do now is inspect the places. I've already inspected the theater, and I've just gotten the keys for the cathedral, so I need to go straight to the cathedral. Yeah, 3 hours left. I've got to go from here all the way over here. It's pretty far to go. What's the shortest way? I guess through the infected region. Go out, hang a right, go to the infected region, go down, cross the bridge, yeah, okay. I also need to take some pain medication because I'm really close to dead, so let's take some Meridorm. Alright, let's go. There's the tick telling me it is 9 PM. I'm not even going to check the clock because if you check the clock, it stops you from being able to move, yet time continues to pass. Not gonna risk it. I'm not stopping for nothing. The only thing I'll stop for is if there's one of those crazy Max Payne looking dudes that's right in the street. Like if he's along the way, I'll talk to him, because time stops when you talk, and I could use a bandage. But other than that, I will not stop. Entering the Plague District. Or a plagued district, rather, for a little bit. So let's keep checking, make sure we don't hit any clouds of nastiness. Plague rat, great. Yeah, guard, you punch that person. Making the world a better place, man. I don't give a damn about that plague rat. I ain't got time for you, plague rat. I'm not gonna shoot you, I'm not gonna stop. I don't care. You keep nipping at my heels. I've got places to be. Shit. I think my health is still going down, even with the Meridorm. My infection's too high. Ironically enough, though, I can't actually take the antibiotics that lower my infection because they hurt me and they will instantly kill me. You really are along for the ride, aren't you, Plague Rat? I can't even stop to heal because then the Plague Rat will kill me. Fuck, my health is going down as I speak. I can see it going down. I might not even survive to the cathedral. I need to get inside the cathedral, though, because then I'll ditch the plague rat and I can heal. Fuck you, rat! I hate you! You're stressing me out even more than I already am. I'm not turning around. I'm not turning around. I'm about to die. No, it's okay. I'll make it. I will make it. The cathedral is here. I just hope to God I can open it instantly. And I don't need to talk to the dude. Please tell me I don't need to talk to the dude. Yes, thank God. Okay, heal. Fucking Jesus. Drugs. What do I take? Tourniquet. Will that increase my health? Oh, only by a tiny bit. Oh, it's because of my exhaustion. Fuck. I think it's my exhaustion that's hurting me. Okay, I've got lemons. There we go. Okay, I might be okay now then. Fuck, I didn't even notice my exhaustion. That was stupid. I'm gonna take another Meridorm. I don't know if they stack. Oh, wait, that increases my exhaustion! That's what probably started killing me in the first place! Eat another lemon. Fuck me. Oh, whatever, whatever. I ain't got time for that. I'm alive. That's all that matters. Got 2 hours. Okay, I need to inspect this place. Cool. Big chair. Red. Gothic. Empty. Alright, we're good. Inspected. We're cool. It's good, right? Would you like to inspect? Yes. So, there really is a spring with drinking water inside? Yes, two even. I think it's going to be very crowded here soon. Do you know there's been some strange sabotage? Someone ruined the town's water supply. And drinking from the river doesn't feel safe nowadays. Should I tell him to not drink the river water? I have heard it smells bad and stuff. So I'd recommend against it. Yeah, you're right. It's best to avoid drinking from the river for now. Okay. I've already seen everything I need. Okay. Cool. Have I seen everything I need? There's supposed to be... supposed to be springs inside of here. I mean, I guess there's this, but I don't... I guess that's what they mean by there being water, is just you can fill up water bottles here. Like, I thought it would actually inspect the water source. That's not the source of the water. That's not the well or the spring. That's just the way you get it. Fuck. Who cares? Apparently I'm done. I'm freaking out. I need to calm down. The quest didn't update. But I guess I'm good? Am I good? I really don't feel like I'm good. Shouldn't the quest have updated? I mean, it's Olgimsky that I'm supposed to report this information to, right? I feel like I should go look behind the cathedral. But I looked behind the other place and that didn't do a damn thing. Look behind the theater. There's nothing back there. I don't have time. I've got 2 hours. I guess I gotta go to Olgimsky. I'm gonna make a hard save here, because I feel like I'm still, like... I feel like I haven't convinced the game that I've inspected these places, and I don't understand how I'm supposed to do that, because of the fact that the quests have not updated by me actually inspecting the places. So I feel like I might have to come back here and do something different. Like, there's something I've just completely missed. For now, I'm just gonna go to Olgimsky and hope that the quest has silently updated. Got 2 hours. 2 hours. And I feel like my health is still going down. But if it is, then it's going down a lot slower. I'm freaking out. I need to lower my infection. I need to sleep. I'm almost dead. At least I'm not hungry. That's the one good thing about my health. My hunger and I think my immunity too. Let's go straight and then hang a left. Ooh. Ooh, 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 this guy might have a bandage. Hopefully he has a bandage and not a tourniquet, because apparently tourniquets suck. I barely healed anything. Oh, useless. Olgimsky, please tell me that I just need to tell you the places are fine, and then everything's fine.
My, Isidora's death was so untimely. He would have known what to do. That was a man like no other.
Okay, thank God it looks like I'm actually good. Did I even need to examine the places? Could I have just given him the keys and said everything was fine? Well, no point dwelling on it. I'm done. The cathedral will serve as an isolation ward. The theater has become a hospital. The morgue will be located in a remote warehouse. Here are the keys. You've done my yesterday's work, haven't you, Doctor? What? What does that mean? My yesterday's work? Are you saying your leftover work? Yeah, well. I've obviously done the job no one else would. I don't know if there's a point to it, though. The absolute mortality rate is a generally recognized fact. Victor, dare I say, has even endeavored to prove it. Did you know? Yes, this is exactly what I've been working on. Yes, there's no one to cure. The only thing we can do is trying to keep those who have dodged the scythe safe. An isolation ward would have been useful, but they say the sand dirt has rather unusual means of spreading. Is it true that it bites at you as soon as you allow yourself to think about it? No, this is absolute rubbish. Is that so? Anyway, dear bachelor, I have a confession to make. You've given me enough hints to show that you already have a suspicion. It's hard, but I cannot allow myself to remain silent. Vlad Olgimsky wants to confess something. Something that he thinks I'm already suspicious about. I'm listening. The disease has infiltrated the termitary. I'm still keeping it locked up. It used to be requisite to keep the disease out, and now I want it in, lest it spills into the streets. And I think you can fathom what that would entail. Okay. Tomorrow we'll have a talk. I want to see it in person. Good, that worked. Finally, I'm actually going to be able to examine the termitary, it looks like. It's been keeping it from me for so long. I want to know what in the hell is going on in there. Alright, is it done? Yes, the main quest is done, thank God. The cathedral and the theater will be used as an isolation ward and as a hospital, respectively. The beak-headed executors have taken up their duties. The masks will take care of the distribution of medicine as well as any postal deliveries. Further to this, they will supervise compliance with the quarantine and the isolation of infected townsfolk. Good. Okay, so I've got like hour and a half or so to perhaps do one of the side quests. So what do I want to do? Do I want to try to take out Barley's men, which I already know are numerous? There's a lot of them, and also I have like no health, so if they get a single hit off on me, I'm dead. Or do I want to go back to the house ninja district and see if I can kill some more house ninjas? If I kill house ninjas, there's potentially quite a bit of loot in it for me. Not to mention the possibility of completing the quest. See, because I thought I completed the quest before when I got, I think, two different crowbars from the looters, from the house ninjas. I thought that was the personal belongings, the looters' belongings that I needed to prove. To prove to Victor that everything is okay, but apparently that's not it, so maybe there's like a random drop chance that they will have a personal artifact on them. And if you don't get that, you're screwed. So maybe if I kill more, I'll find it. I don't know. I don't know. I really don't know. I feel like that quest might be a dead end. I really feel like the crowbar is the dead looter's belongings. That just feels like that would be it. I mean, it's from the looter, and they're dead. It is their belongings. How much time? I do literally have an hour and a half. Well, I was gonna say I'm way closer to the warehouse. The truth is, I'm actually kind of equidistant. I'm slightly closer to the warehouse than I am to this district up here. If I go to this warehouse and I actually kill Barley's men, that means I'm going to use up all my ammunition, and if I get hit a single time, I'm dead, so I'm probably going to be reloading a lot. How's my ammo? I've got 15 shots in my revolver. Like, I have enough ammunition to do it, but it's going to leave me really low on ammo. That's assuming they don't, perhaps, maybe they have loot. You know, maybe once I kill them, their bodies will have lots of good loot. I don't know. There's one thing I do know, though. There is zero chance I can do both. What did Barley offer? Barley said he would shower me with ammunition if I killed Barley's men, right? Or Grief, rather. Grief said he would shower me with ammunition if I killed Barley's men. You know what? Fine. Let's get on Bad Grief's good side. That's a beautiful sentence. Let's do it. Let's freaking do it. I am gonna have to reload a lot. What's the fastest way there? Go south, hit the train tracks, go across the train tracks. Yep. Let's do it. So freaking close to dead. Ugh. I need to sleep. I need to take morphine and go to sleep. I'm gonna make a permasave. But at least I've done the main quest for the day. I'm feeling pretty good. Relatively good. My character is about to drop dead, but I'm feeling okay. Oh, look! Guy who wants to kill me just hanging out in the warehouses. Let's avoid him. Let's make sure my gun's loaded. I'm gonna have to make constant headshots on these people. Elsewise, I will waste tons of ammo and durability of my weapon. I just watched my health tick down. Fuck, it's still going down, and if I take Meridorm, my exhaustion's gonna be so high that I start taking even more damage. Jesus Christ, the only way to recover is to take a really heavy anesthetic and sleep. Or, I mean, I have two more tourniquets, but those barely heal anything. They're garbage. Okay. Almost there. Let's do this. Quick save. Get my gun out. Quick save. Boom. Oh god, reload, reload, reload! Oh! Son of a bitch! I could feel that death coming. And I wanted to sprint, but you can't sprint in this game, so I'm just, like, stuck there. I have to reload. I can't kill them all. Even if I get constant headshots, I have to reload. Whoa. Okay, this time they didn't notice me. Whoa. Hello? Okay, I don't know why that missed. Just wasted two shots there. What? Did I just break the AI? Oh, come on, what? Look at this! What is this? What's with these collision meshes? Bull. Yeah, it looks like if you sneak... I mean, I swear even if I didn't move they were attacking me before, but it looks like if you sneak you're maybe okay. Wow. 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 They're completely deaf. Let's see if I even need to waste ammo. Can I just kill them in one hit? Oh my god, are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Oh, no! Okay, well, I at least can kill the first two with a scalpel easily. Second one looks like he's at a bit of a... too much, like, turn to the side for me to do it comfortably, but I can save some ammo. I didn't realize sneaking was so freaking powerful. I actually want to try this again. Oh, what the? That's so weird. I'm approaching them at the same angle that I approach the other ones at, actually. But for some reason, they're seeing me. I don't know why. I want to try to do this full-on stealth now, actually. Let me see if I can, before I get too close, let me see if I can kill him. Like, can I kill you from here? Yeah. Okay. Oh, oh! Fuck! Alright, forget that. I'm just gonna take out my pistol. So, it looks like shooting them, like, at the top of the head doesn't work, so maybe the neck? Or they're just... What is wrong with the collision meshes in this game? Shoot them in the top of the head? Doesn't matter. Shoot them in the neck? Doesn't matter. Maybe they need to be facing me for the collision mesh to be, like, proper. Just, why don't you just come towards me? There. Oh, okay. Nope, even then, head isn't where the head is. Cool. I love this game, and this is kind of hilariously weird, but sometimes it is... Let's be honest, this game could be better in a lot of ways. And one of the ways, it turns out, is the collision mesh. For the head. Oh, I missed one! Oh! Okay, 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 I think that's it. Quick save. Finish reloading. Quick save. How much time? We got an hour. Let's make sure the place is completely clear, like 100%. Yeah, all right. It is 1,000 million trillion quadrillion percent clear. Let's loot the bodies, loot the chest. Do I have to go back and talk? Well, it doesn't say I need to go back and talk, but it doesn't have the asterisk asterisk thing, which is what shows up after quests are finished, so I think it's not actually finished until I go talk to Bad Grief. And it's possible that if I don't talk to Bad Grief by the end of the day, he won't even acknowledge that I finished the quest. It's possible. So I want to do it today. So let's be fast. Right now I need to loot all the bodies, loot the chest, run to Bad Grief. Nothing in there. Okay, that's it. That's it. Let's go. I have about 40 minutes. Yeah, that's enough time. That's enough time to get back to Bad Grief. Just enough time, but it's enough. Oh yeah, and there was that bad guy hanging out in the warehouse district. I need to watch out for him. Look at how low my health is, it's definitely going down slowly. And my exhaustion is so close to maxed. I wonder if Bad Grief has a bed. Ah, shit, I need to go this way, I think. Okay, he said he would shower me in ammunition. I really hope he keeps his word, because I could use some ammo after that. This is it. Okay.
A wooden neck is tough to bend.
So, Doc, do yesterday's stiffs visit you in your sleep? Which answer do I go with? It's over, Grief. Your former buddies, are no more. Now that's what I call a job well done, Doc. I'll remember not to get on your bad side. You promised me something. My word is solid, it is. I promised to shower you in gifts, so I will. Here are them monies. Do not grieve for it, Grief. Your money will find its way back to you in no time. Probably true. 10,000! You're a fucking sicko, I think, but I want to kiss you. I feel rich.
Wooden neck is tough to bend.
I'm also really close to dying, so I'm going to take a tourniquet. Just to ensure I don't die in the next 10 seconds. Can I talk to you now? No. Okay. Do you have a bed? You do not have a bed. I need to sleep, like, right now. Does Reuben have a bed? I don't think so. I think I can sleep at little Vlad's place. Let's go to baby Vlad's place. Fuck, dead end. As soon as my exhaustion maxes out, which it looks like it already did, my health is gonna go down extremely fast. Oh great, there's a bad guy. Wonderful. Wait, fuck, how do I get around there? Okay, we can ditch him. Good. I want to check how much money I have, because I have 10,000 plus whatever I had before, plus all the money that I got off the bad guys, but, I don't have time. I literally don't have time to check my money. Because I am currently dying. Today will be a better day. Just repeat it. Today, or, well, tomorrow, rather, will be a better day. Tomorrow will be a better day. Anything new to say to you?
Clara has lured Ripper into an ambush.
You know, I still don't remember who Clara is. I still forgot. Anyway, I need to sleep. Okay, I need to take a very strong medication. I don't know if Novocaine or morphine is stronger. It looks like morphine's stronger, so I'm gonna take morphine, and I'm gonna sleep. Oh, also my hunger's pretty high, so just in case my food goes bad during the night, I'm just gonna eat it all right now. Just the bread. I'm not gonna eat the nuts, because I can trade those. Okay. Sleep for 3 hours, see how we're doing. Oh my god, my health is going up. I love it, I love it, I love it. Yes! Oh, beautiful!
The day
Whoa.
Is over. Your timely efforts allowed your supporters to remain unharmed. A new mime performance is being rehearsed at the theater.
Okay, hold on. I need to go back to sleep because my infection is super high. So, my health is max, so I can take the strongest stuff of this if I want. Should I take antibiotics or should I just take Schmouder? That will completely cure it. Let's test out the antibiotics. Let's see what this does. Okay, that actually took my infection down to pretty freaking low. And it really didn't hurt me that much. Should I take more? Or should I just call that good? Maybe I should just call that good. My immunity's kind of low, so I should take some immunity boosting things. I've got max immunity. Taking all that stuff has increased my exhaustion. Let's sleep for one more hour, see how that is. Jesus Christ. Okay, health? Excellent. Immunity? Excellent. Hunger? Gonna need to eat soonish, but I'm doing okay. Exhaustion low, infection low. I think I'm good. I could sleep for another hour, but I think I might be wasting my time slightly if I do that. Yeah. Okay, I'm just gonna call it good right there. I think we're good. Let's make a hard save here. See, tomorrow is already a better day. This is a beautiful day. Let's see what we've got. No quests. Letters. So we're on day 5, right? Yep. No letters, no quests yet. A new performance is being played at the town theater, so let's go visit. I should buy food. See how much it costs for the day, start spending my money. Oh yeah, let's check how much money I have. 14,000? I feel rich. I'm sure that money's gonna go quick, but damn do I feel rich right now. And none of my bars are popping up on the top right of the screen. Yeah, I feel good. Finally got some time to breathe, loot containers. Oh. You asshole. Look, didn't even loot the body. Wasn't even trying to steal anything from her, just murdered her and turned around. I'm sorry. And you're right in front of where I need to go. You... Fuck you. I'm gonna sneak past you. And in the process- oh! Wait, don't kill him yet! I need a barter first. Do you have any bandages, sir? You don't. Okay, you can die now. Sorry. Oh, he is actually looting the body. Oh! Wait. I thought I had, like, max health. Didn't I have, like, max health? Does it actually take you from max health to dead? Just with one knife to the face? I guess it is a headshot, right? Okay, let's try this again. You know what? Got a second here. There we go. Asshole. Unfortunately, I couldn't get him before he murdered the guy. And the guy actually had a bandage on him when I looted his body. Oh, look at his face! He looks blissfully happy in death, doesn't he? That's kind of creepy. Hi. Spare some change for a poor, miserable actor. Give him food. Yours truly would gladly gobble down anything. Even a piece of infected meat from a forbidden storage. I'm so desperate to live just a couple more days to witness the ending. Why do I feel like this person is... like, represents me? A poor, miserable actor. Desperate to live a couple more days to witness the ending. That sounds like me. I'm the actor. You know, playing the role of this character, I'm desperate to live a couple more days, because yeah, I want to see what happens. And the miserable actor is you? That's my persona. A miserable actor. Although, in all honesty, there are no happy masks in The Fatal Loss. And I'll have you know that it's a classical mime play that's been on the stage of our theater for several generations. It only has bold masks, just masks, and miserable masks. I've only seen two masks so far. The miserable one, and the bold one, I presume? It has a remarkably bold beak. You are mistaken. That's not a beak, but rather a talon. No, Bachelor, you've seen the miserable mask and the just mask. That is to say, the punishing one. The bold mask is you. Huh. If there's three masks and there's three playable characters, does that mean each of the characters is one of the masks? Oh my, you must be joking. Oh, that just ends the conversation, damn it. Why are you begging? We've been thrown out of the theater. The fatal loss is now performed right on the streets. But our impresario is convinced that it's for the best. After all, the fatal loss is as tragic a play as it gets. Just see the sick people dancing. Hear the squirming of those whose mouths have been sewn shut. They make for perfect extras. Seems like your troupe is about to become very wealthy very soon. The audience is enormous, but alas, very few of its members are actually financially reliable. Their pockets may be stuffed with coins, but their arms are twisted by the heartless fever that won't let them give away their property. Keep your chin up. I don't think that's useful advice, but, yep.
One of them is trying to fight.
Who?
This one. The other two will try to thwart their efforts, though.
Interesting. Will they fall into the trap?
I wonder. Look what they've turned the theater into.
I hope they know what they're doing. Unavoidably, blood will be shed tomorrow.
Jesus Christ. Oh my God. Why are you still here?
What?
Now is not a good time to talk. Alright. Why would you want to be here? That's a lot of dead people. Every damn place but the stage is just packed. So many are going to be dead by the end of this. You have any bandages? Oh, you do. Lovely. I've started to see the value in bandages even more when you're so close to death. And you can't sleep because you're running out of time. Okay, yeah, so no quests, no letters. I've already read this, right? Yeah. So we don't have any specific quests to do at the moment, so let's make good use of our time. We don't need to sleep. What we do need to do is eat, and I suppose we can go around talking to some of the main people to see if they have anything to give us, any side quests or anything like that. So let's look for food and maybe go talk to the Canes and talk to Ava. Oh, that's medicine. I believe this place right here is food. Yeah, let's actually go talk to Lara, see how she's doing. Because she's supposed to die at some point soon. According to the... I forgot who told me that. The executors or the masks or something. So I want to keep checking on her. And also, she gave me free food once, so perhaps she'll do it again. Here's some food right over here. Oh god. Oh god. New. No. Hello, clone. I'm praying that the prices are not ridiculous. Before it was like, what's 800 or 1600 for a can of vegetables? What is it now? I think it was maybe like 900 or something. I'm not entirely sure, but I think that might have gone up a little bit by like maybe 100 or something. But it's not terrible. Not terrible. Wow, I've got like no room in my inventory. I need to start bartering. Should I grab an egg? I think I'm just gonna stick with the canned vegetables. Yeah, my hunger's still pretty high. Let me see how much the egg gives you. It's the same price as the vegetables, so if it gives you the same amount as the vegetables, then it should be fine. Hunger's halfway. I'm not sure how that compares to the vegetables. I feel like it's a little bit less, but I'll stick with it. Yeah, I'm like seriously about to run out of space. I really need to barter or store my stuff, and I believe there's actually a table you can store your stuff at Ava's place. Like a nightstand or a little chest or something. So I could store some stuff there if I need to, but I'd rather just barter it all away. And I really don't want to dump my stuff. Because I get so time limited that if at any point I need that stuff and I'm out and about, like, I really don't want to take the time to go back just to collect stuff. I feel like that's too dangerous to part with stuff that I might need just because there's, like, never enough time. Let's go talk with the Canes. Still haven't received any letters or anything. Start with you. Anything
where
new?
Where do the dead go?
Headache. Sorry if I'm bothered. Yeah, nothing new to say. Then let's talk with Victor, and then I forgot the other guy's name. Victor and Georgie. I think his name is Georgie. I know it's a Russian name and not actually pronounced that way, but whatever. He's Georgie boy.
That does it. I'm gonna break soon.
Okay, this is new. If the new governor carries on like this, strife will certainly be unavoidable. This is a judicial temper tantrum, a result of total impotence on the part of the authorities. What are you talking about? Several dozen innocent people have been thrown in jail. An even greater number have simply been killed in the streets. But those, at least, were robbers and looters. These poor other people got locked up just because patrolmen didn't like their faces. Who is in jail? First, there were mass arrests because of yesterday's act of sabotage. They took everyone who had taken part in breaking the water supply. Even those who they thought could benefit from the act in some way. That is how several selfless volunteers ended up in jail for distributing water. Such a bloody shame. You'll be even less pleased to find out those people were arrested on your authority. It was claimed you were the one who had discovered the roots of this conspiracy, and that those roots turned out to be quite sprawling. I certainly never approved indiscriminate arrests. I see. Anything else? Secondly, in went everyone who was armed. Alarmed, people had been preparing for fights with the savage Barley's barbers. Many had armed themselves with knives and even pistols in order to protect themselves and their loved ones. This is absurd. And finally, they arrested poor souls caught searching dead bodies, and the buildings already gutted by marauders, including brothers taking lockets from their dead sisters, and homeowners returning to the ashes of their homes. Jesus. How much do I trust Suvorov? Or Sabarov? Wait, I thought his name was Suvorov. Is it actually Sabarov? Have I been mispronouncing it the entire time? Well, I mispronounce a bunch of other people's names too, so... oh well. But how much do I trust him? Do I think it's a patrolman that did it? Or... Suvorov? I guess I won't know until I talk to him. But I'll give him the benefit of the doubt, because I haven't... as far as I can remember right now, I can't remember anything particularly nasty from Suvorov. He does like power, that's for sure. But I can't think of anything nasty that he's done off the top of my head. However, I can think of something nasty that the patrolmen have done. And that is stop me from getting the tissue sample from the dead body and trying to punch me to death. So, yeah. I'm sure patrolmen abusing their power are to blame. Suvorov most certainly knows nothing about this. I will talk to him and restore justice. Alright, so I think we have a side quest for the day.
Suvorov has started a pointless manhunt.
Yep, so we've got our first side quest for the day. Let's go talk with Georgie. Yes, I know his name is not pronounced Georgie. But I've grown to like the name Georgie. Therefore, I've renamed him.
I have a heartache.
I guess I'm going to see my brother soon enough. Are you talking about your forthcoming death? I never expected you to give in to despair so quickly. Don't be the man that would jump to false conclusions. I never said I was going to die. I'm only saying that my brother is going to come back to us very soon. What? How could that be? To bring one's dearly departed back to life, there's no need to indulge in the farce of spinning tables, galvanization, and overturned tombstones. This spectacle is powerless to meet all but the most immature expectation. The fact of the matter is that the dead linger inside us, their living counterparts. That's some Eastern philosophy. I wouldn't know. What I do know, however, is that the dead may be brought back to life by the focused emotions of the living. It's ludicrous how people picture a soul as an ethereal imitation of whoever it belonged to. It doesn't even occur to them that a soul is more resemblant of music than a human figure. Huh. That was poetic. Quite so. There are people whose memory is merely a sequence of simple melodic fragments. Then there are those whose memory is more like a symphony. The more subtle a soul, the harder it is to retain it and reproduce it. It would require very special instruments, like any music does. If this is the way you want to reunite with Simon, I can only respect your resolve. That was fascinating. I wasn't expecting that from him.
What does she need in the cathedral? There's no one to heal there. The sick are taken outside.
What does she need in the cathedral? Who is she? Also, wasn't I gonna go speak with Lara? I never did that. Why did I never do that? I guess I just forgot. Huh. Whoops. Yeah. I stopped here for food, right? But then I didn't go to Lara's place, I think? Whoops. Let's go visit the cathedral. Bachelor Denkovsky, I'm not sure what your instructions were, and what Big Vlad's opinion on this is, but we've only received a tiny fraction of the food supply required. People demand that we let couriers in. I'm sorry, I can't give you food. I don't even really have any right now, to be honest. I've only got, like, walnuts, I think, and that's about it. And maybe a lemon. I know the town is starving. They know it as well. The goods train is going to arrive very soon. They'll have to be patient. If you say so. Perhaps you would like to know there are more than 700 people inside. Even the upper galleries are crowded already. 700? There's no way this place could fit 700. Maybe if every single person was simply standing, just packed together, but I'm not even sure 700 people could fit in even like that. Let alone enough room to actually, you know, go to the bathroom or sleep. Whoa, I can say we can use the structure on the other side of the river even though it's usually off limits. What structure is that? We're talking about the polyhedron? If so, I don't see how I have the authority to allow that. It just doesn't seem like my business to mess with that. Aren't only kids supposed to go in there? I guess technically maybe I do have the authority, but that doesn't feel right. I'm gonna say it, though. I want to see what happens. No, you know what? I'm scared. I'm scared if I say that, that's gonna do something horrible with a polyhedron or something. Let them brace themselves. It won't take long now. Yeah, I can't go inside. You made a wise choice, Bachelor, but we've encountered certain complications. What is it? There are already 500,000 people who have agreed to leave the infected districts for the cathedral. It's you who they owe their lives to, Bachelor. You've mentioned complications. There are food issues. Huh, this is... I'm confused. This is like the same conversation that I just had with the other guy, except a bit different. We have enough water, but the people are starving. People are getting cranky. They want to be allowed to go search for food in the clean districts. I can't let them out. That defeats the purpose of an isolation ward. So what do I want to say? That we'll have the vaccine done in a few days? No. That's way too hopeful. I can't possibly promise that. But what I can promise is I'll speak to Olgimsky. You will be getting food supplies. I mean, I can't promise that they will be getting food supplies, but I can promise I'll speak with Olgimsky. Do you want to talk about the same thing? Bless your wits and wisdom, Dr. Denkovsky. get stuffed. What's the happy occasion? You provided people with a shelter, everyone gathering at the cathedral. It's a real cathedrally. It's a cathedral cathedrally? What? What the hell is wrong with you? What kind of shitty joke is that? 350 people have already agreed to come over from infected districts. Oh, really? Bachelor, the credit for all the lives saved today is yours. You've made a very wise choice. Why do I feel like everybody inside is going to die and that there's something very, very wrong with the cathedral? Come now, no need to blow it out of proportion. I've got a really bad feeling about this cathedral. Also, I just realized this episode is going on super long at this point. Alright, well, I guess I'll end it here then. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I'm going to go speak with Ava, see if she has anything new to say for the day. Then after that, I will go to the town jail, at the town hall, and see if I can follow up on that side quest.